Next, we will see IEEE 802.11 project. So IEEE has defined some specifications for wireless LAN. That project is called IEEE 802.11 project. So we can say that wireless LAN, in short, it can be called as, in public, it is Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is wireless fidelity, or which is a synonym for wireless LAN. Okay, so first we will see the architecture of this 802.11 IEEE project. So this architecture, it provides two set of services. One will be basic service set, other one is extended service set. Basic service set, in short, it is called BSS, and extended service set, it is called ESS. So coming to basic service set, these are the basic building block of wireless LAN. So what do you mean by basic service set? It is nothing but, it can be of two types. One is, it is can be called as an ad hoc network, or it can be called as an infrastructure. What is ad hoc network? That is, a basic service set means it consists of a mobile station, a station which can freely moves in one place to another place. That is a mobile station, or it can be a stationary station. So within a particular network, we have some stations which is mobile or stationary. Those are called as ad hoc network. So here, basic service set without an access point. So the next type in basic service set is an infrastructure based, where we have an access point. This is called an access point. Using this access point, what we can do is, we can able to send data from one basic service set to the another basic service set. So here in this ad hoc network, we cannot able to send data to another basic service set. If we want to send data to another basic set, then we should go for infrastructure based basic service set, which has an access point. Okay, so this is the basic service set. And what is extended service set? So if we want to connect with another basic service set, we should go for this extended service set. Here in this extended service set, you can see there are three different basic service sets, which through access point, this is an access point through which they are all connected through a shared medium called distribution system. Here they can be a wired one, or they can use a wireless medium. Okay, and which is again connected to a server or a gateway. So this is an extended service set. So if you want to send data from one basic service set to another basic service set through access point, you can able to send it. And this type of a service is called extended service set. So here, what are the three types of stations available is, the first station is no transition mobility. So what do you mean by no transition mobility is, a station, that is a station which is moving inside this basic service set, is called no transition mobility. So no transition mobility means a station which can move only within this mobility, which can move only within this basic service set. That is no transition mobility. What is basic service set transition mobility? So that is, a station can move from one basic service set to another basic service set, is called the second type. That is BSS transition mobility. What is BSS transition mobility? A station which is having this property can able to move from one basic service set to another basic service set. That is called BSS transition mobility. And what is ESS transition mobility? A station with this particular property can able to move from one extended service set to another extended service set. So you have two extended service set. So when you want to move the station from one ESS to another ESS, then it is called ESS transition mobility. So there are three types of stations available. One is no transition mobility, where the stations cannot able to send the data to another basic service set. They can send only within the basic service set. The second one is BSS transition mobility, where the station itself can move from one basic service set to another basic service set. It is called BSS transition mobility. And third one is ESS transition mobility, where a station can move from BSS one ESS to another ESS. Okay, now we will see the MAC sublayer in IEEE 802.11, that is wireless LAN. So in this MAC, so first we will see the MAC sublayer. So data link layer is divided into two types, two sublayers. One is logical link control layer and MAC sublayer. So, and again we have the physical layer. So coming to MAC sublayer, it is again divided into two sublayers. One is distributed coordination function, other one is point coordination function. So it is divided into two sublayers: point coordination function, in short it is called PCF, and other sublayer is distributed coordinated function. DCF. Okay, so first we will see what is distributed coordination function. Now we will see in detail on this layer called distributed coordination function sublayer. So coming to distributed coordination function layer, first we will see the exchange of data, how it helps to exchange the data between the stations. So here in this diagram, you can see source destination B, and you have other station also in the network C and D. First, station A, if it wants to send the data, it will check whether the medium is idle. If the medium is idle, it will wait for a period of time. That period of time is called as distributed interframe DIFS, distributed interframe spacing. It is called distributed interframe spacing. So when the medium is idle, the sender A, it will wait for attempts. When the medium is idle also, it will wait for a period of time called distributed interframe spacing. Then the station will send a control frame. That is, the control frame is called as RTS. What is RTS? Is request to send. It is called request to send. It will send, it is asking the destination that it has some data, whether I can send the data to you. So it is asking the request. So after which the B, after receiving this RTS packet, it will also wait for a period of time called SIFS, short interframe spacing. It is called short interframe spacing. So after waiting for this SIFS time, then the station B will send CTS packet. CTS packet is nothing but clear to send. So this will say that I am ready to accept the data. This clear to send packet control frame is sent by the destination to the source to say that it is ready to accept the data. Again, this source will be waiting for DIF, that is SIFS. It will wait for SIFS, short interframe spacing. It will wait for this time, then it will start sending the data. Now it starts sends the data, and after sending the data also, this destination will wait for this time, SIFS time, and it will send the acknowledgement. Okay, this is the process of exchanging the data between the two stations. So whenever station A wants to send the data, it will check whether the medium is idle. If the medium is idle, it will wait for this particular time, distributed interframe spacing. It will start sending the control frame. That control frame name is RTS. RTS is nothing but it is a request whether I can send the data or not. So after receiving this, whether B is ready to accept, then it will send the CTS packet. It is called CTS, is clear to send. Then it will wait for SA first time, and after which data will be sent. Here also it will wait after data has been transferred between the two stations. Now the station B will send the acknowledgement to A. Okay. Now we will see how collision is avoided in this particular transmission. So when RTS packet will contain, that is the duration of time it needs to occupy the channel. So the RTS packet, when it is sending the RTS packet from source to destination, it will contain the duration of time that source A is you going to use the channel. So after getting this, the destination will wait for SIFS time. It will send the CTS packet. So when it is sending the CTS packet to A, this destination B will also send the CTS packet to C and as well as to D also. It will send the CTS packet to C and it will send the CTS packet to D also. So what is the meaning of sending the CTS packet to C and D is, CTS packet is being sent from B to C and also to D, saying that I am going to use the channel and for this much amount of time. So when it is going to send this, so now C and D will start a timer. The timer is called as NAV, that is called network allocation vector. This negative, this NAV is network allocation vector. So they will start a timer and both C and D will stop accessing the channel at that time. So because of this, collision will be avoided after NAV time. So now this data, this while it is after the data has been transmitted between A and B, so now this destination B will also send the acknowledgement. It will also send this acknowledgement back to this C and as well as D. Now this channel is free, so they have exchanged the data. So now the station C and D, they can use this channel. So here what happens is hidden problem, hidden station problem is also avoided, since we are sending the clear to send packet. The station B, it is sending the packet to source, and also it is sending the packet to C and D, informing that it is that both A and B is going to have a transmission for this much amount of time. So this both the C and D will start a timer called NAV, that is called network allocation vector, during which they will not access the channel. After finishing the transmission, the station B will send the acknowledgement to A and also send the acknowledgement to C and D, saying that it has finished the transmission. Now they can use, anyone can use the channel. Okay. Now we will see the frame format of this wireless LAN. So coming to the frame format, it has 9 fields. So in this 9 fields, first the field is frame control, which is of 2 bytes. Next is destination, which is of 2 bytes. And D is duration. And third one is address field, address 1, address 2 and address 3, which is of 6 bytes. And next we have SC, that is sequential control. And then we have address 4, that is 6 bytes. And next field is the body, that is like the data which has to be sent. And the last is frame control sequence, which is of 4 bytes, which is used for detecting the errors. First we will see one by one. So first field is frame control. So frame control field, it is again, it has subfields. So the first field is protocol version. So the current version is 0. So this will specify the version of the protocol which you are going to use it for this for sending. And the current version is 0 now. Okay, next is type. Type field will tell you what type of information, that is type field will tell you that is it, what type of information you want to send. Suppose if it is for management or if it is for control information, and then or otherwise it is used for data information. Management information means it will be 002 bits. Control information is 01. Data means it is 10. Okay, and next is subtype field. Subtype field will tell you whether we are going to send a request to send. Okay, that we will see in one more subfield afterwards. Okay, and 2DS. This also will be defined afterwards. Next is more fragment. Coming to more fragment field, when this field is this more fragment, this when this field is set, it means we are sending, we are require more fragments. When this field is set to 1, we require more fragments. Okay, next is retry field. Retry field will, when this field is set to 1, it means that it is a retransmitted frame. It is retransmitted frame. So we are going to send a frame which is to be retransmitted. Next is power management. Power management, PWR, MGMT. This is when this field is set to 1, it means the station, it is in power management mode. So it is in power management mode. So when this field is set, it means that it means in power management mode. Next is more data. So when this field is set to 1, it means that station has some more data to send. It has some more data to send. And next will be WEP. WEP is nothing but wired equivalent privacy. Wired equivalent privacy. So this will be used for encryption and decryption purpose. So for this we have WEP 1 bit we are having. Next one is reserved field. So reserved field, we are going to set this field to be 1. So whenever it is necessary, we will use this. So the frame control field, which is of 2 bytes, which contains all the subfields. So first is protocol version, and then the type of the information we are going to pass, whether it is management, control or data, and subtype. Then 2DS and from DS, which will be explained later, and more fragment, when this field is set, it means that we require more fragments. And retry field will tell you we are sending the retransmitted frame. Power management frame, this field will tell you whether the station is in power management mode more data field will tell you that we require some more, we have some more data to be sent. WPEP is wired equivalent privacy, which will be used for encryption. If encryption is implemented, then we will set this bit to 1, and last is reserved bit. Okay, coming to the frame types, we have this IEEE 802.11. It has 3 types of frames. Okay, 802.11, we have 3 types of, 3 categories of frames. One is management frame, control frame, and last one is data frame. Okay, coming to management frame, so when we have to do an initial communication between the stations and access point, so we can use this management frame. For sending an initial communication between the station and access point, we can use management frame. Control frame, this is used for accessing the channel. So when we want to access the channel, or when we want to send the acknowledgement frame, then we can use this control frame. Okay, so the structure of the control frame, it will have the 2 things. One is, we have already seen RTS and CTS. RTS is request to send and CTS is clear to send. RTS packet will contain this data fields. One is frame control, which is of 2 bytes, and D is the duration of accessing the channel, and address 1 is the sender address, and address 2 is the destination address, and we have frame control sequence. So this is the date, this is the frame for RTS packet. CTS packet, if you see, it will take frame control, duration of time during which it is going to access the channel, or it is going to do the transmission, and then we have address 1, that is destination address, and frame control sequence. This is the control frame. So coming to the subtypes, so we have already seen this is the type. So when we have seen the subtype over here in frame control, that is in the that is like in the frame format, we have seen the subtype. So coming to the subtype, so it can have 4 it can have 3 category. 1011, it is of 4 bits. When it is 1011, it is called request to send. When it is 1100, it means that it is clear to send, and 1101, it is acknowledgement frame. So we need to, if we send these particular bits, it means that it is sending the these packets. Request to send, clear to send, acknowledgement packets. And last is data frames. Data frames are used for carrying the data and control information. So when it wants to carry data and control information, it can send this structures. Okay, but we will be discussing, we will be using only this control frame, because we, since we are using only RTS CTS packet in this, so this only these has been explained over here. Okay, so in this frame format, we already know that we have frame control. This is a entire frame structure. So one by one, we are discussing, and we have discussed the frame control. So in that, we are discussing the type. So coming to the type, it may be of the several types. It can be management frame, control frame, or it may be your data frame. In control frame, it can we can send either RTS packet or CTS packet like this on a subtype field. This subtype field, it can be of, it is a 4 bit, so it can be 1011 means it is request to send, or otherwise clear to send, or it may be acknowledgement frame. Okay, now we will see the addressing mechanism. That is, like here in the frame format, we have 2 DS and F. From DS, DS is nothing but distribution system, and from DS is that is from the distribution system. Or so here 2 DS, it can take 2 values, like 0 or 1. So here it may be 00, it can take 01, or it can be 10, and last is 11. So we will see case one by one, all the cases. First, if the 2 distribution system is 0 and from distribution system is 0, so that is the case 1. So here it will be having 4 addresses. So since address 1, address 2, address 3, and address 4, address 1, this 1 represent address of the next destination. Address 2 is the address of previous device that the frame has left, and address 3 is address of the final destination which you want to send, and address 4 is original sender. Okay, so address 1 is address of the next device, and address 2 is address of the previous device, and address 3 is the final destination, and address 4 is sender. So we will take the first case when 2 distribution system is 0 and from distribution system is 0. That means we are sending a frame only between the devices A and B. We are not going to use any access pointer. So that is 0 and 0. So in that case, so the frame that is like the cases in this, the addresses will be, since we are going to send it to 2B, So the address 1 is B, and address 2 is, we are sending it from A, so it will be A. And here address 3 is who's is to whom you have to send, that is like third is final destination, it will be based on the basic base service set. Okay, and the next coming to the case 2, case 4, the address 4 is not defined, we doesn't know the original sender who has been sent. Now coming to the second case, where you have two distribution system is 0 and it has come from one distribution system called 1. That means it has been sent, this frame has been sent from a distribution system. That means from one access point to this particular station inside basic service set. So what happens over here is, so this frame has been sent like this. So here address 1, 2, 3, 4. In address 1, it is, we are going to send it to B, and from where it has come from access point, so access point 2, address 2. Address 3, who's the final destination, so final destination is A over here, and we doesn't know who's the sender, so that is who's the original sender of this particular frame. Next, coming to the third case, where it is two distribution system is 1 and from distribution system is 0. That means 10 is the third case. So here we are going to send it to an access point in distribution system. So we have sent it like this. So in that case, who is the destination? Destination is access point, and the source, the previous device is A, and who is the final destination in this? The final destination is B, and here also we doesn't know original sender. Last cases, it has come from one distribution system and it is going to another distribution system. So the two bits will be 1 and 1. So both the access points are going to communicate in this. So who is here the destination is access point 2 is the next device. Previous device is AP1, and who is the final destination is B, and original that is sender is A. So these are the addressing mechanism in case of your IEEE 802.11. So here 802.11, it uses two. So in this we have two bits, that is two distribution system, and from distribution system it can have two bits. It can be 00, 01, 10 or 11. Coming to 00, in that case we are going to send the data from within the basic service set. So the destination 1, that is address 1, will be the next device will be B, previous device is A, and the final destination is any station inside the basic service set. Coming to the second case, so here we are going to send the packet from the distribution system to the station inside basic service set, so it will be 0 and 1 over here. So here it will be, the next station will be B, previous station is AP, and final destination is A over here. The third case, we are going to send the packet from the station inside BSS to a distribution system, that is called access point. So the next device is AP, previous device is A, and the next final destination is B over here. Coming to this fourth case, when we are going to communicate the packet between one AP to another AP. So here it is, the next device is AP2, the previous device is AP1, and the final destination is B, and the sender is A. So these are the addressing mechanism which you'll be using in case of your IEEE 802.11. So in this 802.11, we have discussed the architecture, and we have discussed the sub layers, and we have discussed all the addressing mechanisms. Okay, thank you.